Now, if you kept up with our Gen Con videos throughout the years, you know Fantasy Flight has a tendency to announce something mid-Gen Con. And they did not leave us hanging there. They announced the new Star Wars game, Star Wars Legion, which is actually a miniatures game involving, as you can guess, Star Wars characters. Jonathan was very lucky and got a chance to sit down at one of the tables, I guess you'd call it, and play a little bit of it. So, Jonathan, what was it about?
So, as you said, Star Wars Legion, we first heard about it. There were rumors just a day ago that there was going to be a Star Wars miniatures game from Fantasy Flight. And, of course, we said, aren't there already four of them? but this is essentially a ground-based combat game, very similar in playstyle to X-Wing or Armada, where you have your ground units and you are moving them with your, you know, whatever they call them, they're your range tools, your measurement things that tell you how far they can go and what they're in range of on a map. Of course, they had these beautiful painted minis and backgrounds and dioramas set up that you're not going to be getting in the box. But
you don't get that whole Tatooine table there?
Right. I believe they actually said a 3x6 space is what you play it in. I'm sure there's different variations you can do if you don't have the table for it. But essentially, it is a lot like X-Wing with maybe sort of a little bit of Imperial Assault in there, in that when the attacks, you, for instance, have surges on your dice, and you can use those to spend them on extra abilities that you have. The other thing that I thought was really cool that's different about it, you move as a unit, and each unit has a leader. So, for instance, I was the Empire, and I had Stormtroopers.
Of course you'd be the Empire.
I know, I insisted. And if I move my leader Stormtrooper, he's got four or five buddies, and all of them get to move with him as well within like one movement range space.
So it really does support more of that squad based fight.
Yeah, definitely. And even they don't even have to be behind him either. They could, as long as they're within the certain range, you could have guys out in front. The other thing that's cool is there's cover, there's barriers, so that will affect your attacks. I also had Darth Vader, which was awesome. He can move and then attack in for free if he moves twice in a row. So he can, like, he's slow, but he can potentially get up on you and do a huge attack on you. You're rolling dice. Like I said, if you are familiar with X-Wing, it's a miniatures game. It's that kind of a thing. But I really liked that, unlike the ships in X-Wing, as you might guess from ground units, it felt much more mobile. Like, you could, it didn't take you a really long time to turn around or anything like that. So that part was cool.
So do you know when this is planned to be released?
I think they said 2018. I don't think it's this year. I also asked about stuff like MSRP and how they're going to be selling it, like how the packs are going to be like, and they just haven't said yet.
So do you even know whether it'll come painted like X-Wing or not painted?
It will not come painted. You're going to paint them yourselves if you want to do that, but the ones that they had were really nice.
They only care about starships painting.
That's at least in the base. I mean, who knows down the line what they might do.
All right, so sounds like if you're into miniatures, I mean, you're probably going to at least take a look for this.
Yeah, if you like X-Wing and Star Wars, this will definitely be right up your alley. Thanks for watching. For more Gen Con coverage, make sure you like and subscribe to this channel, and follow us on Twitter and Instagram at RollForCrit.
And to keep up to date, you can check out RollForCrit.com/GenCon2017 in order to get the latest, greatest news on Gen Con from RollForCrit.